And now we're about to see two veterans of the game fight off to see who gets to join the new blood in the finals.
It should be very exciting to see which of them do it. You know, both of them very accomplished players. So, you know, people that we've seen go deep before. Colin, the defending champion of this regional. Yep. We saw his opponent from last year's finals fall to James there. So we can see if Colin can do what he did last year or if we'll see two new members of the final this year.
Yep, front page news. You have to be here to see who's going to make it to the finals now. And again, it could be either Colin, it could be Wesley. Both of them are very evenly matched.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, both of them had a really strong tournament so far. Colin's had one of the best years of anyone so far with the win in the top eight. He's actually now ranked fourth in North America.
Yeah,
so
insane.
Definitely one of the strongest players after finishing third at the World Championship last year. So certainly someone everyone should be looking out for right now.
Yeah, and this is his team on screen again. That's that Salamence, Rhyperior, Heatran, Cresselia, Thundurus, and Sylveon. And again, an incredibly decorated player. But he will be facing off against Wesley Morioka, who is no slouch himself. Again, formerly a national champion and a regional champion, but now trying to make a mark on the 2015 metagame with that Gardevoir, Salamence, Washrotom, Excadrill, Terrakion, and Thundurus.
Yeah, so two very different teams here. You see Colin kind of running one of the more conventional teams now. You know, he's got the option of Trick Room. He's got a bunch of the more common Pokemon. He's got a lot of bulk on his team. Wesley, his team's a little bit crazier, right? We saw that Moldbreaker Excadrill you don't see too much of.
The
Choice Scarf Gardevoir, which will be an interesting contrast to the Gardevoir most people have been using, which have been the Mega version. So kind of a fun throwback there.
Yeah.
Definitely something I'll be excited to see as we get into the game here, see if Gardevoir can have another big series, because it's not something that I've seen much of recently.
Yeah, let's get right into the game. That's Colin Heyer on your screen. Again, third place at Worlds last year, defending regional champion, up against Wesley Morioka, 2010 U.S. national champion. Going to be an exciting match here. That's Wesley's team on the top of your screen. We'll be looking at it from Colin's perspective, so he'll be on the bottom. Really interesting team matchups here, and I have to feel like in this sort of high-pressure first game scenario, I would expect Colin to fall back on the Trick Room.
Yeah, I would too. One fun part about this best of three is since they both saw each other play their top eight matches, they know a lot more than they would normally know in a best of one situation. So I'm guessing they've both probably spent the entirety of the last semifinals kind of trying to plot for how they want to handle this series. So I'd expect they'll probably both come out of this one playing a little bit quicker than maybe they normally would. I do think that Colin's Trick Room mode is something that he'll likely try to lean on. He didn't get to see the Thundurus from Wesley in the top eight match, is actually pretty important because he doesn't know whether or not it is taunt. If it does have taunt, obviously, that's something that makes it a little bit more difficult for him to get Trick Room going. But if he doesn't have it, there's probably not a whole lot of greedy answers to Trick Room on the team in general. So that's something that potentially Colin could run away with the series with. You know, we see that Choice Scarf Gardevoir, which is not
pretty
very
useless.
Good in that Trick Room. You know, Terrakion's quick. Mega Salamence is quick. Excadrill is at least quicker than Trick Room Pokemon. Thunder is very fast. He definitely doesn't want to give up an easy Trick Room, does Wesley, or he is going to be in for a World of Hurt.
Yeah, and it looks like Colin's going to try and put Wesley in that World of Hurt immediately. Cresselia and Sylveon on the field up against that Thundurus and Salamence for Wesley. Now again, crucially, Colin has not seen that Thundurus before. A taunt would be disastrous for a Cresselia, especially if it really is trying to get up that Trick Room.
Right, I think Colin's been using a more defensive Cresselia as well. However, I mean, there's always ways around that taunt even if you have it. We'll just see what he does here. Also, you know, Sylveon is a great partner to that Cresselia. You know, we saw before the excellent strategy of what happens when you leave Salamence in with Sylveon, so it's not too likely that Wesley's going to go for that this time. It creates a lot of pressure here.
Or he will go for it, but also protect the Salamence. So Salamence is still on the field, but not great. Looks like there is no taunt coming out from that Thundurus, just a Thunder Wave onto Sylveon, which, normally good, but if that Trick Room goes up, you just made Sylveon the fastest thing on the field. Dealing a lot of damage to Thundurus with that Life Orb, but Trick Room goes up. So Cresselia and Sylveon even paralyzed, Wesley really just has to hope for a fully paralyzed.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I guess without taunt, because Thunder Wave is the next best thing, but really rolling some dice there. We also see leftovers from Thundurus. Usually we see that Citrus Berry with both Rotom and Thundurus in the team. Part of why most players don't normally do that in addition to, the stacking electric types is that they both really want Citrus Berry.
Yeah.
So leftovers is some good information for Colin as well, since we didn't see either electric type Pokemon in the previous series.
Yeah, Wesley has to retreat that Salamence, though, in the Trick Room with that Sylveon paralyzed in favor of Gardevoir, going to trace the Levitate from Cresselia. Worst things have happened. Thunderwave onto Cresselia for Wesley. Just going to have to try and hope for some coin flips here. Not getting them right now. Sylveon's Hyper Voice connects to Thundurus. Actually is going to be able to just come so close to picking up a KO there. But the Ice Beam from Cresselia onto Gardevoir going to bring both of those Pokemon down to basically, Hyper Voice KO range. And Leftover is really saving Thunderous that turn.
Yeah, I mean, I guess Citrus Spurs would have as well, but it's certainly feeling good about not having, like, Life Orb or something right about now. So Thunder surviving for another turn, but Wesley's got to be really careful here. We mentioned it didn't look like he had a great answer to Trick Room, and not only does he not, but he's got to worry now about how he's planning his endgame. You know, Salamence is one of his two remaining Pokemon that is at full health, but Cresselia's Ice Beam, Sylveon is a Sylveon.
Sylveon gets off the Hyper Voice, gets two free KOs, it's whatever.
Whatever, this game's going okay for Colin, I guess. Really, a big issue with Salamence, like I said. It can't stand against either of these Pokemon. So unless Wesley does something really crazy with his remaining Pokemon, it's going to be time to go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a better solution to Trick Room than Thunder Waving the non-Trick Room Pokemon.
Yeah, I mean, judging from the Pokemon that Wesley has chosen, it looks like he just does not have a response to Trick Room. And this is why Trick Room is so dangerous, because, if you don't have a response for Trick Room, you just get rolled by a Sylveon.
Right.
And you have to hope for a fully paralyzed. And that's about it.
Yeah, and there's still, I mean, we haven't seen most of Colin's team here. Could have Salamence, could have Rhyperior. He could have, even Heatran could potentially be pretty dangerous to these Pokemon here, as long as he can keep it away from Excadrill's ground type attacks. So, not good. Wesley's really, even if he'd managed to deal with Sylveon, it's not like the game would have been his. So he's really going to have to try to find a better way to slow down Trick Room, at least punish the setup turn, because he has a very fast team that is going to have a hard time stalling this out.
Yeah, just going to have to Mega Evolve the Salamence and probably just hope to stall out with Protect and some lucky Fully Paralysis here. Hidden Power from Sylveon actually going to take down that Excadrill. Not even going to attempt to go for the Salamence, predicting that one out. Super effective damage, but not able to get the KO. Cresselia finally is paralyzed, and now Excadrill is able to use that Iron Head onto Sylveon, pick up the first KO for Wesley, which is a little better than I expected given the position that he was in. But, one KO, pretty good, not good enough.
Yeah, definitely not. I guess an Ice Beam from this defensive Cresselia is not going to be enough to finish off that Salamence in zone. So the game isn't over, but certainly a very disadvantageous position for Wesley to be in here.
Yeah.
He gave up too much in the beginning of the game. Like, he can try to stall a Trick Room now, but even if you don't have a great answer for it, sometimes if you can get a big burst of damage and then sacrifice the right Pokemon, you can win once Trick Room is up. But Cresselia is still at full health. Rhyperior is still at full health.
We haven't seen
the last Pokemon, which is likely a quick Salamence. It's just a tough position for Wesley here.
Yeah, Excadrill going to hide behind the Protect, finally getting another Paralysis onto the Cresselia, but Rock Slide from Rhyperior is going to connect with the Salamence and deal about 50% damage. Dragon Pulse coming out, though, still going to be able to deal some damage back. So Rhyperior taking some damage, not super effective damage, not going to activate the Weakness Policy, and Trick Room has ended, and Wesley's sort of getting some rolls. Maybe he can stall it a little bit longer, maybe just go for some Rock Slide flinches.
Yeah, he's going to need Cresselia to fail to get Trick Room up, most likely, and also fail to Ice Beam, but he's going to get some damage out here with this Hyper Voice.
Yep, Hyper Voice comes out, not very effective on Rhyperior, and a critical hit on Cresselia. Drill Run from Excadrill, just trying to make sure that the Trick Room sweepers aren't on the field. So all of a sudden, Wesley is now 2-2 against this Cresselia and whatever is in the back. Cresselia is going to be able to get the Ice Beam off, so no Trick Room coming back up, probably meaning there's a fast Pokemon for the fourth. Salamence finally is going to faint, and now Cresselia against that very weakened Excadrill, and then the fourth Pokemon in the back.
Yeah, absolutely. Does look like, and it
definitely
is Salamence like expected. So Salamence can get this Intimidate off. It'll be quicker of an Excadrill and be able to finish this one out pretty cleanly.
We've already seen the Earthquake. No chance of missing there.
Right. So a very well-played game by Colin. Wesley started closing things up a little bit at the end, but you kind of have two big opportunities to deal with Trick Room if you've not got a good counter. It's before it gets set up, and then right after it expires the first time. And he missed one of those windows.
Yeah. Did pretty okay, considering how bad of a situation he got put in at the very start. But definitely not going to be able to repeat that performance.
Yeah, no, I don't know if he just wasn't expecting the Trick Room mode or what, but he definitely going to need to look for a better way to deal with it this time. Even if it's just something like Thunder Waving Cresselia and then Iron Heading it with
with Excadrill.
Excadrill, yeah. Like, as weak as that sounds, like, it's much better than just accepting it's
accepting
going to go
it
up.
Going up and then trying to paralyze the other one.
Right. Yeah. And I think also, Gardevoir probably is going to need to stay
sit
at home
this
in this one.
Out.
Yeah. Like, unless he really, really thinks he needs to deal with Mega Salamence, mm-hmm. In which case he's really in trouble here.
Yeah.
I'm feeling like you need to be able to protect against Trick Room, and Gardevoir is both frail. And that's the thing that's amazing against the rest of Kalen's team. Like, you know, it's great against Salamence, obviously, but, you know, what is it going to do to Sylveon, to Rhyperior, to Cresselia, to Thundurus, to Heatran? Like, it's
exactly what we just saw, Faint.
Yeah, it's...
So, going to have to get into Game 2, see if Wesley can make those adjustments and have a bit of a stronger Round 2 than the first game. But, again, there's Colin on your screen up against Wesley Morioka. Again, Wesley's team, Thundurus, Excadrill, Salamence, Washrodom, Gardevoir, and Terrakion up against Colin's Cresselia, Salamence, Thundurus, Rhyperior, Heatran, and Sylveon. And I have to wonder if Wesley was just trying to bluff a taunt that first round and then hopefully go for something a little bit better.
Yeah, it kind of seemed like it, right? Just like, maybe he won't go for the Trick Room. I mean, we've seen that from other players, right? I mean, like, mm-hmm. Like James knew he was going to get taunted in the semifinals, so he just went for the Ice Beam. Unfortunately, Colin didn't do the same thing. We also haven't seen Cresselia's item yet, so that could have something to do with it. But a really unfortunate way for that to play out for Wesley.
Yeah, definitely going to have to make some adjustments here in turn zero, the leads, and just really hope. Rotom and Excadrill on the field now. A little bit of an adjustment up against Cresselia and Rhyperior. So Rotom a better matchup against the Rhyperior than Wesley had against the Sylveon at first. So a little bit better for Wesley on this time.
Yeah, it's a better situation, sort of. I mean,
he
doesn't really have any way to stop the Trick Room. When Trick Room goes up, he's in a better position. Rhyperior's not going to deal with Rotom very well, mm-hmm. so it's likely there would need to be another switch by Wesley here. If I was him, I'd probably double target this Rhyperior with Iron Head and Hydro Pump so that Sylveon can't get in for free. But wisely, Colin's going to deny that opportunity and play fast this game.
Yeah, just going to bring in the Salamence already. Rhyperior retreating, gets the Intimidate off onto Excadrill, making sure that it can't deal that much damage. Drill Run onto Cresselia. So Wesley just going to try and deal as much damage to the Cresselia as possible. And Will-O-Wisp from Rotom trying to neuter whatever switches in, gets the Salamence, which we've already seen has a lot of physical attacks on it. Not going to be great to be burned, but Toxic coming out from that Cresselia. As you mentioned, usually a tech against Calm Mind Cresselia, pretty good against Rotom, too.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, he doesn't have a whole lot of Pokemon that are going to deal big damage to Rotom, and neither Salamence or Rhyperior are going to be very effective at that. So that Poison will slowly whittle it down, maybe get it in range where you can pick it off with one of those Pokemon without having to dedicate a whole bunch of turns to wearing it down. But getting that burn on Salamence is actually very big for Wesley. He started out much better than the last game. Little surprised that Colin didn't just go for the Trick Room since he was in a relatively safe position, but you know, Salamence being burned, most Salamence do carry a special move even if they're a physical set, so he's not totally hampered here, but it's going to hurt.
Yeah, the Mega Evolution into the Draco Meteor, as you said, they always carry some sort of special attack. Draco Meteor connecting with Rotom, and that's a whole lot of damage, but Rotom actually able to tank it very well. Rock Slide from the Excadrill as well. Going to deal good damage to that Salamence. Maybe get a flinch onto that Cresselia. So some damage and another Will-O-Wisp. So just trying to whittle down Colin's team. Wesley playing a little bit slower this game. Doesn't really have that many other options. Trick Room does go up, but with just Salamence out, it's not too bad.
Yeah, I mean, Salamence isn't going to do anything with that Trick Room. So for Wesley then now, it's just a matter of figuring out when Colin is going to switch because it's not an if anymore. And hitting the right slot. Like, Salamence does seem like the obvious target to switch out, but I'm sure he's perfectly aware that Wesley has figured this out as well, so he may choose to keep Salamence in a little while longer. Though with that burn ticking down and the special attack drop from Draco Meteor, Salamence isn't going to get much done. Actually, a very good position for Wesley for the most part, even though Trick Room is up. Colin's going to have to switch before he can take advantage of it. Both the Pokemon Wesley has out probably have Protect, so we can start stalling that Trick Room. Wesley's actually the one in control of this game here, and Colin's going to need to make a very decisive play in the next two or three turns, or Wesley's probably going to be able to carry this game to the end.
Yeah, it's a little confusing to me that Colin decided to play the fast mode instead of just going with the Trick Room that was so dominant in the first game. Ice Beam onto the Excadrill, dealing a little bit of damage and freezing the Excadrill. You don't want to see that. Frozen Solid Excadrill and a Will-O-Wisp from the Rotom onto the Salamence, not having anything to do with that as well. Earthquake coming out, burnt, going to deal some damage to the Excadrill, but that freeze, that's rough.
Yeah, I guess Ice Beam freezing is a way to make a big play. It wasn't quite the sort of thing I had in mind, but I mean, Excadrill is not doing too much now. he's stalling his own trick room now, I guess, which is a little strange. But, you know,
And Salamence doesn't really mind being out against a Rotom that's poisoned and, you know, ticking down.
Yeah, I mean, since Salamence being burned is not going to accomplish very much anyway, it's working pretty well for him to just, you know, let Toxic the two burns and Excadrill's health slowly whittle down. Perhaps, you know, Colin thinks that he's going to win with whatever he has in the back. But since we don't know what either side has in the back at this point, other than Colin's Rhyperior, pretty gutsy play.
And having Rhyperior in the back could end up being an issue for Colin, given that Wesley does have some tools to deal with that Pokemon. We are going to see the Excadrill immediately switching out, not just going to let the frozen Excadrill sit around. And Gardevoir switches out, gets aerially from the Mega Salamence. And now another Ice Beam onto Rotom. Rotom is poisoned, so it's not going to be able to get frozen, but takes a little bit of damage. Hydro Pumps the Salamence, deals a little bit of damage as well. That combined with the with that burn will put Salamence into pretty good KO range. Unfortunately, unable to get the Levitate for Gardevoir, so he's going to take some damage from this this Earthquake, but mostly a free switch-in.
Yeah, I mean, he's slowly wheeling down the Salamence, making sure that it's not safe for Colin to switch out into Rhyperior, because you know that's still a big threat. And he gets Gardevoir in here, which obviously doesn't like Trick Room very much, but, you know, Trick Room's slowly ending. That's the weakness of the fact that, you know, slowly time is getting burned away here.
Yeah, and also Cresselia is getting pretty low, too.
Right, yeah, so both these Pokemon being weakened severely, unless the last Pokemon on Colin's team is, you know, something that's going to function very well out of Trick Room and help deal with this Gardevoir. Wesley probably has this one. Colin just not being able to get too much done here.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what that fourth Pokemon is. Wesley going to switch out the Rotom, going to preserve it for just a little bit. Excadrill comes out. Of course, the Excadrill is frozen, so not going to be able to deal a whole lot of a whole lot of threat. Cresselia's Toxic onto Gardevoir, also not able to deal that much damage, but, you know, going to be able to put a timer on Gardevoir. Frustration from Salamence onto Gardevoir, correctly identifying that Gardevoir is a threat, actually gets the KO through the burn. So Gardevoir goes down, and that's a pretty free KO.
Yeah, I assume Wesley assumed he was going to survive that one, but, you know, Gardevoir very frail on the physical side. Salamence very strong on it, and, you know, in spite of the burn, getting a pretty important knockout there. You know, with that knockout, the Excadrill frozen, I don't know, maybe Colin can pull this one out after all.
Yeah, Excadrill's really going to need to unfreeze to give Wesley a chance, especially now that Sylveon's out. Gonna have to hope for that Trick Room to end and then fire back against the Sylveon, but, you know, that Excadrill's still frozen.
Yeah, I mean, it's a pretty low percentage chance every turn to get unthawed as well. Sylveon will likely take care of this one before Excadrill even gets the chance to do anything about it. And
Excadrill thaws out for the Protect. So Excadrill's actually going to be able to do something about it. Double Protect from Excadrill, and Salamence going to stall out that Trick Room and just hope to get some offense off now that Excadrill is finally cooled off.
Yeah, pretty clutch Excadrill play, except the Trick Room being used there, returning the dimension
to normal. Okay.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised, but I don't know if Colin miscounted Trick Room there or what, but I believe it was going to expire at the end of that turn anyway, so a little strange not to see an Ice Beam, even though he would have whiffed it anyway. So now we have Excadrill, who should be faster than Sylveon. Cresselia is going to have Faint to burn this turn anyway, though probably it needs to be knocked out to avoid the threat of Trick Room going up for real this time. Tight turn here, but Wesley has the advantage now.
Yeah, Mega Salamence on the field, and somehow Wesley has been able to come back from this, you know, pretty major team disadvantage and get himself into a good position. Hyper Voice from Salamence going to KO that Cresselia. No more Trick Room option for Colin. And Excadrill now going to be able to use that Iron Head onto Sylveon. Should pick up the KO pretty easily. And now Wesley getting a KO. You know, I'm not sure how, but he's somehow gotten himself to a position where he's about to take game two.
Yeah, he certainly has. Colin's strategy for this game was not what we expected, to say the least. And I think there's no chance that Rhyperior is going to survive and be able to fire back a weakness policy boosted attack here, but I don't know if it's going to be enough. So likely that Wesley's going to take the second game.
Dragon Pulse from Mega Salamence onto Rhyperior. It's going to deal a lot of damage, just a little bit under half. Drill Run from Excadrill, probably enough to pick up the KO. Yes, so no weakness policy. Wesley takes game two, and all of a sudden we got a series.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised that we do in some ways. I don't understand what Colin was thinking with the strategy in that game. You know, he had that dominant game one. Game two, he didn't really choose a second mode so much as choose an absence of a mode. It felt like the whole game he wasn't doing anything. I was kind of surprised he got as close as he did, and without that freeze, that game could have been even more,
one-sided.
Yes.
Yeah. I mean, for the most part, his trick room was spent with Salamence on the field, which was bizarre. Hopefully, for Colin's sake, he can go back to the dominating performance we saw game one. We're going to go right into game three and see if he can pull it off, or if Wesley's going to come back from a pretty significant disadvantage, take game three and move on to the finals.
Yeah, and we kind of see how Wesley became a national champion, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, forgetting everything else about that game, he's in a bad matchup. He doesn't give up. He plays it as well as he can, and he takes a win here. And now he's getting, just as good of a shot as Colin is taking this series. You're always going to end up in a tournament in team matchups that aren't favorable to you, but sometimes you just have to find ways to win them anyway. And Wesley's in this one. I do expect that Callan's probably going to play this game a little bit more conventionally.
Yeah.
He didn't really play the last game as a Trick Room hybrid so much as, just a team that had the move Trick Room. I'm expecting that, he'll either commit to going fast early or commit to going slow early, because he had to get caught in the middle there where he got Salamence burned, so it wasn't doing much damage, and it was dangerous for him to switch out to the Pokemon he had in the back, so he got stuck.
So just wasting Trick Room turns.
Yeah, so I think he'll probably learn from what happened there, play this game a little bit more carefully, and set him up in positions where he can maneuver better, because he just ended up in a situation last game where he couldn't do much but wait for his own Trick Room to end, and that's a losing strategy.
Yeah, well, we are going to see that infamous pairing, the Cresselia and Salamence, as the leads for Colin this time up against the Excadrill and Gardevoir. So interesting choices. Gardevoir traces the Intimidate, going to be able to intimidate the Cresselia, and the Salamence really still wanted that Levitate. Now that we know that Salamence has the Earthquake, pretty dangerous.
Yeah, I mean, I would like this team matchup, or the lead matchup, I should say, a lot more if I'm Colin, though. Mm-hmm. I'm going to assume he still has his slow Pokemon in the back and just wants to adjust how he plays the game. So he gets the Intimidate and Excadrill. Gardevoir isn't super threatening to probably either Sylveon or Rhyperior in the back. So if he wants to, he can get the Trick Room here. He just has to be careful about Wesley deciding to get cheeky and Iron Heading that Salamence slot.
Mm-hmm. Well, it looks like Salamence is actually going to stay in for this first turn, Mega Evolving right away. I mean, pretty dangerous to Mega Evolve right in front of a Scarf Gardevoir that is going to be able to launch a Dazzling Gleam. So calling the bluff, Dazzling Gleam dealing a lot of damage to Salamence. Salamence going to get the Earthquake off, though. This is Intimidated, so may not be able to pick up as much damage as he wants. Good damage onto Excadrill and Gardevoir, but, still surviving, and Rock Slide comes out from Excadrill onto Cresselia and the Salamence. Salamence just barely hanging on that as well, and Cresselia flinches. So finally some flinches from that Rock Slide.
Yeah, I mean, you fire off enough of them, you're going to get some. a little strange that once again a Salamence just isn't afraid of Fairy-type attacks.
Yeah.
They do a lot of damage.
Yeah, unsurprisingly, these Fairy-type attacks are taking down the dragons. Another Dazzling Gleam will pick up the KO onto Salamence, and a little bit of extra damage onto that Cresselia. Iron Head from Excadrill going to deal even more damage to the Cresselia. Trick Room does go up, though, so Colin just trying to use that that Salamence for the Intimidate, and hoping for the KO on it so he can get a free switch in for Trick Room.
Yeah, I mean, he was sacrificing Salamence, though. That's kind of the solution, I think, that he found to what happened to him in the previous game, is that he realized that his problem was he could never switch in safely, and he was wasting turns of Trick Room. So he gives up Salamence, who at least gave him some pretty good damage and some board position with Intimidate there, gets Rhyperior in safely the first turn of Trick Room. In some ways, the flinch almost helped him. He doesn't get to preserve Salamence, but he gets the free switch and gets Rhyperior in a turn sooner in Trick Room as well. So not too bad for Colin here. He's starting up behind on the scoreboard, but this is kind of what we talked about in game one. When you can't punish Trick Room very well, you've got to do whatever you can to make the setup hurt and then try to win afterwards. So it'll be Wesley's job now to try to stall out the Trick Room and not lose too much before it expires.
Yeah, and Wesley is immediately stalling with that Protect on Excadrill, but Earthquake comes out from the Rhyperior. Gardevoir probably not going to be able to do anything. It did its job for this game, took out the Salamence. Faints now, so back to even, but now Wesley's going to get a free switch as, potentially has that Rotom in the back, which would be very strong against this Rhyperior. Does come out, and we did see that Gardevoir, even against this heavy Trick Room, managed to do work.
Yeah, I mean, you got a knockout there, and a very important one, and weakened Cresselia. A little surprising that the situation came up that allowed Gardevoir to do work, but right. You know, I guess when you're using a Pokemon like that again, you know, it's similar to the Yanmega thing. Like, nobody else is using Scarf Gardevoir, so if you're using it to get to this point in the tournament, you know how to get the most of it, and Wesley does there, and he's still in a pretty strong position here. Now, Rhyperior being threatened by Rotom is going to make this very difficult. Even if Cresselia gets a Toxic off or something, valuable turns of Trick Room are going to get burned here, but Rhyperior just goes for the Earthquake.
Yeah, Wesley, just keeping his Pokemon in, is going to take an Earthquake to Excadrill. That leaves Wash Rotom able to punish the Rhyperior, but... You know, we'll have to see if Wesley can make use of this. Obviously, sacrificing that that Excadrill here. Ice Beam from Cresselia, dealing just a little bit of damage to Wash Rotom. May get the freeze. Probably not. Will-O-Wisp comes out from Rotom, so not going for the damage, just for the safer the burn here. Doesn't want to risk any sort of, you know, Hydro Pump misses in activating or activating a weakness policy without getting the KO.
Yeah, I assume he was expecting a switch there, and that's why he left Salamence in. Or I'm sorry, left Excadrill in. Mm-hmm. But a very dangerous play there because. Kalen is continuing to play fast, right? Like, if he traded Rhyperior for Excadrill there and brought in Sylvia, the game would basically have been over, assuming that's his last Pokemon. Mm-hmm. So Wesley almost playing into the hands there, but by choosing to burn instead of Hydro Pumping there, he gives himself a much better chance of stalling out the Trick Room and then getting the speed control advantage again. So a good play by Wesley not to pick up the knockout there, even though you look at that and like, wow, you know, why didn't you just switch out for Salamence? Yeah. Still, it wasn't the worst thing that could have happened to him that turn.
Yeah, and the Intimidate and the Burn onto the Rhyperior are going to make sure that, you know, this heavy sweeper that you would normally expect in Trick Room is a little bit less effective. So Mega Salamence, Mega Protects, and that should be another wasted turn of Trick Room, as the Rock Slide not going to deal any damage to Salamence, just going to be able to deal a little bit of damage to the Rotom as well. Critical hit, that's all it did. And Toxic from Cresselia onto Wash Rotom. So putting the Wash Rotom on that timer again, will slowly whittle it down, gets the flinch. You know, you could flinch in Trick Room too. It's not just Landorus that can flinch with Rock Slide. But another turn of Trick Room stalled out.
Yeah, and burning the Salamence to protect is a big deal. If Salamence survives this turn, Wesley's got a great shot at this game, but a combination of Rock Slide and Ice Beam will probably still get it, even through the burn and the Intimidate, unless Salamence is trained very specifically.
Oh, tries for the double protect, does not get it. Rock Slide from Rhyperior instead, going to deal damage to Salamence and Rotom. Almost no damage dealt to the Salamence, though. Ice Beam from Cresselia, it's a very super effective attack, but it's not going to be enough anyway. And Rhyperior avoids the Hydro Pump. So Wesley, thinking that he had to go for the double protect there, turns out he didn't. And unfortunately, Rotom misses the Hydro Pump, and so Colin just gets a whole lot of free damage.
Yeah, that winds up being a tough break for Wesley there. If he'd known he was going to survive, he could have just fired off a Hyper Voice and would almost have closed the game for him here. Instead, Rhyperior still has a bunch of health. Salamence is going to have a difficult time. If it's being very close, whether or not it can just take out Cresselia in a single hit here. Mm-hmm. If it can, he probably still has that one. But even so, this is a very special-oriented Salamence, the only exclusively special Salamence we've seen so far.
Yeah.
And it's going to make it difficult to deal with the last Pokemon if it's Sylveon.
Yeah, especially with Dragon Pulse not picking up the KO. Hydro Pump, though, is going to finally connect onto that Rhyperior. So that's going to be the end of Rhyperior. But Cresselia is still up, still able to put in the Trick Room. And if that's that Sylveon in the back, Trick Room's up, Sylveon's in the back, that should be game.
Yeah, absolutely. It's Wesley must be kicking himself for going for that double protect now.
Ooh. That's an unfortunate break for Wesley there. Gotta know your calcs.
Yeah. Well, and who doesn't know their burned, intimidated Rhyperior calcs? Unfortunately for Wesley, we knew it was going to be close either way, and it just hinged a little bit the other direction. Sylveon coming in here, and it should be able to close this one for Kalen, but man, what a close series this has been.
What a surprisingly close series that it's been, too. Cresselia getting the helping handoff onto Sylveon just to make sure that, you know, the MVP of Colin's team deals as much damage as possible. Going to only be able to deal damage to the Rotom, as Salamence has protected. So with that poison and with the helping hand Hyper Voice, Rotom will faint. Salamence, I guess Wesley could try to go for, you know, another four protects.
Another four protects and then get like a Hyper Voice crit, but like it has like four crits in one attack to...
Yeah, maybe.
It's looking bad.
Yeah, Salamence goes for the protect again. Unfortunately, Salamence just was never going to get that double protect off no matter what he did. And Colin Hire picks up the win 2-1 against Wesley Morioka and moves back to the finals of Madison, Wisconsin.
Yeah, you don't see that too often, right? He won this tournament last year. He gets back to the finals for a second year in a row.
Yep.
This is just his tournament, apparently. So he'll face off against James there after a very close series between Colin and Wesley.
Mm-hmm.
It looked like for a while there that Wesley's going to be able to pull it off against all odds, no matter how bad his team matchup looked. But Colin got it back under control there. He played that game a lot smarter where he didn't really expose Rhyperia or Sylveon to unnecessary risk until he was ready to start trading knockouts.
Mm-hmm.
And he just had a little bit more bulk and a little better combination of bulk and power, I guess, than Wesley's team did. So he could trade a little bit better, where Wesley's team has that power but not the bulk to back it up, other than Rotom, which lacked in the power department, especially as he's having a little trouble aiming today.
Yep, definitely. And I'm really impressed that Wesley got as far as he did against this team, but Colin just proving why he's the highest ranked person at this regional right now. I mean, there's a reason why Colin got third at Worlds, why he won last year, and why he has always been a threat at any event he ever goes to.
Right, absolutely. I mean, I think Colin also kind of had the more complete team here, where Wesley's team had a lot of fun tricks on it, but it's hard to look at that and just think, this is as solid as Colin's team is, where Colin's got much better balance of offense and defense. He's got options to play with Trick Room. He's got options to play with Thunder Wave. Just is a little bit more on the table on Colin's end. It makes it a little bit easier to play through a long series like this one, where Wesley kind of ran out of tricks. He had to use that Scarf Gardevoir, for instance, which actually did a surprising amount of work for him.
Yeah.
But he didn't really have an option, right? He had to use what he came with, where Colin had a few more tricks to work with had he needed them. Though I guess even on his side, it ended up being coming down to more of not what he brought, but how he used it, and playing it a little bit safer.
Yeah, and it's going to be very exciting to see Colin face off against James Beck in our finals coming up very soon. We're going to take a quick break right now. When we come back, we'll actually have an interview with Colin. And then after that, we'll have the finals, James Beck versus Colin Hire, here at the 2015 Pokemon Video Game Regional Championship in Madison, Wisconsin. All right, everyone. Welcome back to the 2015 Pokemon Video Game Regional Championships here in Madison, Wisconsin. I am Evan Latt, and I am joined by a familiar face from yesterday's stream. Colin Hire has fulfilled the promise that he made yesterday, and he has made it back to the finals of this regional. Now, you made it back to the finals. Are you going to win?
I think I'm going to win, yes.
You think you're going
to win? I'm going to do everything in my power to win.
All right, well, if you put the full force of your power behind it, then I don't know if anything can stop you. Let's talk about that last match real quick.
Mm-hmm.
It seemed like you had a very advantageous team matchup
over
Wesley. Didn't really have that much of a response to the Trick Room. But we saw, in the second and third games, you weren't able to be as dominant in your Trick Room option. Was that sort of a conscious decision not to go as all-in immediately, or was that just sort of an unfortunate happenstance?
In game two, when I brought Salamence in under the Trick Room, he could punish any switch into Rhyperior to try to gain momentum. So I kind of put myself in a loss of momentum because I had Cresselia Salamence in Trick Room instead of Cresselia Sylveon or Cresselia Rhyperior. So that was kind of on me. And then game three was me just trying to let Salamence die really quickly so then I could get in with Rhyperior or Cresselia and Rhyperior or Sylveon with Cresselia and sweep.
And it looked like Sylveon did a whole lot of work for you. Obviously, you brought your Sylveon with you. Would you say that Sylveon was your MVP for the tournament?
Yeah, for sure. Sylveon and Rhyperior is close, but Sylveon's MVP.
So Sylveon's an interesting Pokemon because at the start of the season, Sylveon either wasn't seen very much or it was seen on pretty bad best of one teams. What is it about Sylveon that specifically has made it, better now? Is it just that people have figured out how to use it better or people aren't countering it as much?
I definitely feel like people are less prepared for Sylveon because it's not, it's died down in popularity. When we first got the game, Sylveon was everywhere.
Right.
It was broken or however you want to say. But now it's kind of slowed down, so people are they're not bringing two steel types. They're not playing Bisharp or Kangaskhan as much anymore.
Yep.
So Sylveon's really able to go. Its middling speed also, I think my team / Crow's team definitely gives it an advantage because of its slow speed. So in Trick Room, it's doing
it works
tons
really
of
well
work.
With that sort of Trick Room, Quick Room sort of team archetype. So looking ahead to the finals, Unfortunately, you don't get your rematch against Manoj. Instead, you have to face off against the person who bested him, James Beck. I'm sure that you've been watching some of the matches. How do you feel those matches will go for you?
I definitely feel like I think I can outplay him. I think I am the better player. I don't want to get too cocky, but I think I have more experience in best of three. He did make it to Worlds last year through the LCQ, so he does have that same best of three, but I think my team's amazing, and I think I can do it.
Well, I'm excited to see that match. It promises to be a pretty exciting matchup. I could not have, you know, we got a really great top four out of this. We got a great top eight, and the finals is also going to be really exciting, and I'm very much looking forward to it. Congratulations again on beating the finals bar that you set for yourself. Saved it.
Yeah.
We'll be back in just one moment with that finals here from the 2015 Pokemon Video Game Regional Championships in Madison, Wisconsin.